Hey there, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to fix the 409 conflict error. When you attempt to view a website, you may see an error message that prevents you from accessing the page. If the server notices a conflict between the HTTP request and the resource, it will display a 409 conflict error. In this video, we'll show you how to check your website for the issue and fix it if necessary. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's get this 409 conflict error fixed. Even after you experience a 409 error, there are a few ways to resolve it. If you're unsure what's causing the issue, you may have to try a combination of different methods. Here are five of the most common fixes. Before you try more complex solutions, it's a good idea to review the requested URL. If you manually entered this information, you may have accidentally made a typo that caused an error in the request. If you made a mistake in this data, you can correct it and try the request again. Sometimes, this will enable you to continue with the request without causing a 409 error. You can also try simply refreshing the page. Sometimes, old errors can disappear given enough time. Plus, the website owner could have already resolved the issue. When you first view a website, your browser stores that page's data in a cache. This way, you can easily re-access those resources. Once you visit a site a second time, your browser will pull the cached data instead of requesting the resources from the server. After you've recently fixed an error in your request, like a mistyped URL, you may still see the 409 error. Although the issue could already be resolved, the error message might still display because of your browser cache. In this case, you can clear your cache to remove the HTTP status code. The method you use to do this will depend on your browser type. For Google Chrome users, you can start by clicking the three-dot icon in the top right corner of the page. Then select More Tools, and then Clear Browsing Data. In the new pop-up window, select Cached Images and Files. If needed, you can also clear your browsing history, cookies, and other site data. Then click on Clear Data. Although this will clear most of your cache, your browser will still likely keep additional data that most users don't want to be deleted. However, if you want to remove your full cache, navigate to the Advanced tab. Here, you can select the data you want to delete from your cache. You can choose from these options. Once you specify the information to remove, click on Clear Data. Now you can try the request again to see if the 409 error has been resolved. Sometimes HTTP error codes can be caused by conflicting software. To troubleshoot a 409 conflict error, consider downgrading your WordPress website. This downgrade can help you evaluate whether the core software conflicted with other tools on your site. However, you'll need to back up your website before starting this process. If not, you risk losing important changes you made with this new software update. After troubleshooting the issue, you can quickly restore your site to its former state. Since Kinsta performs daily automatic backups, you can downgrade WordPress by restoring a previous backup. To do this, click on the Backups tab in your My Kinsta dashboard. Then, select the backup you want to restore. Click on Restore To, and choose whether to implement these changes in your staging environment or live site. Finally, confirm the restoration by entering the given text. If you updated your website long ago, you'll likely need to use another method of downgrading your site. Since Kinsta only saves your daily backups for 14 days, you may not be able to restore to an older version. As an alternative, you can install the WP Downgrade plugin. This tool will enable you to easily reinstall an older version of WordPress. First, install and activate the plugin. Then go to Settings and then WP Downgrade. Enter the exact number for the previous WordPress version to downgrade your software. When you're finished, save your changes. You may want to consider rolling back your computer update as well. For Windows users, you can do this in your update history settings. You can also downgrade a Mac computer by reverting to a Time Machine backup. If you don't want to downgrade your website completely, you can deactivate your plugins and third-party tools. By removing this software, you'll likely eliminate any conflicts. To deactivate your plugins, go to the Plugins page on your WordPress dashboard, then select all of your plugins. Click on the Bulk Actions menu and select the Deactivate option. To finalize these changes, hit Apply. Now you can try the request to see if you received the 409 error. If the request is successful, you know there was a conflict with one of your plugins. To identify which plugin is causing the issue, activate each plugin one at a time. After each activation, check to see if the error happens again. Once you locate the problematic plugin, you can delete it. If it performs a necessary task on your website, consider browsing the WordPress plugin directory for an alternative. Usually, you can find a different tool with similar functionality. Alternatively, there could be an issue on the client side of the request. To solve a 409 error, you can disable your browser extensions. On Chrome, go to More Tools and then Extensions. This will open a list of your enabled extensions. To disable them, make sure the switch next to each one is turned off. You can also delete the extensions completely. This should eliminate any software conflicts. However, you should only do this with unnecessary tools. As a last resort, you can check your server configuration for errors. In My Kinsta, you can use the built-in APM. With this APM tool, you can identify any long external requests, unoptimized plugin code, and slow database queries. To open the Kinsta APM, sign into My Kinsta. Next, head to Sites and then Kinsta APM. Then, you'll have to enable performance monitoring for a certain period. At the top of the page, click on Enable. In the pop-up window, select the amount of time you want Kinsta to evaluate. You can enable a monitoring time between 2 hours and 24 hours. After you enable performance monitoring, you can use your results to troubleshoot the 409 error. You'll be able to view all your requests and analyze your server's response time. Alternatively, you can use the Query Monitor plugin. This free tool enables you to see the performance level of your database queries, scripts, hooks and actions, block editor blocks, and more. First, install and activate Query Monitor. Then click on the New tab at the top of your WordPress dashboard. Here, you can view reports for your site's queries, requests, scripts, and other data. Under HTTP API calls, you can see a list of any request errors. With either of these tools, you can easily find 409 errors and discover the root cause of the issue. Then you don't have to waste time troubleshooting other areas of your website. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.